And it's really interesting because the bond market seemed to take Powell's words well, but with the equity market, the gains were a little bit more muted if we look at the S&P 500 to begin with, which really suggests that trade concerns are something that equity investors are still grappling with.
Right, no, absolutely. I think the trade picture is still relatively unclear. But I think the one thing to really think about is if you looked at the movement in the equity markets over the last few weeks, I think it's fair to argue that markets were anticipating exactly what happened with the Fed yesterday. So it's not unsurprising in the least that you would have a muted reaction when, in fact, one would argue that this expectation of a rate cut was probably already priced into the market.
So what do we need to see then for the S&P 500 to hit that record high yet again? The Fed to deliver, or is it something out of the G20?
I think it's a combination. For right now, it's fair to say that central banks are in control. And I think we could say that if go back all the way back to last October. Clearly, what we're seeing is the impact of Federal Reserve and central bank policy via the discount rate, which has come down pretty substantially since peaking last November, early December. So Federal Reserve are in control, but as equity investors, we're really focused on earnings expectations. And one of the things that's holding back earnings expectation is this uncertainty around trade and where things are going to go from here.
Yeah. Speaking of uncertainty around trade, in your portfolio, you're looking at small caps. And, you know, if you look at the chart, you can see that small and mid caps have really underperformed amid increasing geopolitical risk. Not necessarily surprising, but what's your outlook from here then? Does it mean that small caps actually have further to rally if these uncertainties go away? Or do they sort of stay underperforming as this geopolitical risk goes on and on and on?
two things to think about. On the one hand, small caps are clearly a proxy for risk appetite in the market. So to the extent that investors remain concerned over these broader geopolitical issues, I think it's fair to say that small caps probably struggle from here. But the second, which I think is just as important, comes around to giving the leverage that small companies have to the domestic U.S. economy. Mm-hmm. As much as we're focused on these global issues, I think what's going to be even more important for smaller companies is what happens with the U.S. economy moving from here. Now, even absent all of these things that we're seeing around trade, we've seen clear evidence that the economy was slowing. I don't think there is any evidence right now that we're heading into a recession, but we certainly seem to be on a glide path back to trend growth, which will be somewhere in the 1.5 to 2% range.